Now that we've discussed finding LCDs to clear fractions, we need to talk about factoring denominators. To identify all the factors in the LCD, we may have to factor the denominator. In example 1, we see that these two denominators are already factored, but this is a trinomial that most likely does factor. Many times there will be one of these factors in the third denominator that needs to be factored. It's just something to keep in mind. This factors to x minus 6, x minus 7. Look at that. It does match the other two denominators. So our LCD for this example is going to be x minus 6, x minus 7. If we multiply through to each term in our numerator that same LCD, all our denominators will drop out and we will no longer have fractions in our equation. It's a little difficult to squeeze these LCDs in here, but it's important to understand the steps that we're going through. Notice now that our denominator of x minus 6 divides out, but x minus 7 stays in the numerator. X minus 7 divides out in the second term, but x minus 6 stays with the numerator. And x minus 6 and x minus 7 divides out in the third term, and nothing but technically a 1 would stay in the numerator. Now we can rewrite our equation. X times x minus 7 plus 1 times x minus 6 equals negative 3x minus 8. From here, we can distribute the factors outside parentheses, which gives us x squared minus 7x plus x minus 6, because 1 is not going to change anything, equals negative 3x minus 8. From here, I'm going to add 3x and add 8 to both sides. This gives us x squared minus 4x plus x plus 2 equals 0. I can add these two terms together and I get x squared minus 3x plus 2 equals 0. At this point, I can factor my quadratic equation. Set my factors equal to 0, and the solutions for x are 2 and 1. In example 2, we see that we have fractions once again, but this is not completely factored. This factors to x plus 3, x minus 3. Notice that the other two denominators are identical, so our LCD is equal to x plus 3 and x minus 3. If I multiply my LCD to each term in my equation. My denominators will divide out. X plus 3's divide out. X plus 3 and x minus 3 divide out in the second term, and x minus 3 divides out in the third term. I will now have 2 times x minus 3 for my first term minus 9x equals 1 times x plus 3. This gives me, distributing the 2, 2x minus 6 minus 9x equals x plus 3. From here, I can add like terms, and I will get negative 7x minus 6 equals x plus 3. I'm going to subtract x and subtract 3 from both sides to set my equation equal to 0. This gives me negative 8x minus 9 is equal to 0. Solving for x, I get dividing by negative 8, x is equal to negative 9/8. Notice that I set it equal to 0, but that there was no quadratic form in this equation, so then I just isolate x. That is my final answer.